Hello everyone. Today we will be discussing about carbonization process and two different methods, Behave Cocoven and Otto Hofmann's byproduct Cocoven to produce coke for the metallurgical processes. Now, what is carbonization process? Carbonization process is nothing but conversion of coal into coke. That is, when coal is heated in absence of air, it forms a strong, porous, dense and coherent mass known as coke. There are two different types of coals, caking coals and coking coals. Caking coals means the carbonization gives, after carbonization, the coals becomes soft, plastic and fused together to a large coherent mass. These types of coals are known as caking coals, and this is difficult to be oxidized. Now, for the coking coals, if the coke obtained is porous, hard, strong and usable for metallurgical process, then we can say that the coal that is used is nothing but coking coals. There are two different types of carbonization: low temperature carbonization and high temperature carbonization. So let us discuss what is the difference between these two. As the name suggests itself, low temperature carbonization means the carbonization takes place at a low temperature of about 500 to 700 degrees centigrade. It contains 5 to 15% volatile matter and it cannot be used for the metallurgical process. But it ignites easily and easily it is used for the domestic purposes. The coke obtained is smokeless, and even the byproduct gas that is obtained by the process have a high calorific value of 6500 to 9500 kilocalorie per meter cube. But it is not suitable for the metallurgical processes. Now, in case of high temperature carbonization, the temperature is about 900 to 1200 degrees centigrade. So at this high temperature, coal is converted into coke, and the coke produced will have high strength, purity, hardness, desired porosity, and it can be used for the metallurgical purposes. And it has very low volatile matter, that is of about 1 to 3%, and it has a calorific value of 5400 to 6000 kilocalorie per meter cube. So the coke formed by low temperature carbonization is not suitable for metallurgical purposes, and the high temperature, the coke formed by the high temperature carbonization is used for metallurgical purposes because of its high strength, purity and hardness. Now, coal on carbonization gives various product other than the coke also, like coal tar, ammonical liquor, coal gas, naphthalene, benzene, H2S, all these are the byproducts. Even this coal tar can be further fractionally distilled to get different types of oils, light oil, middle oil, heavy oil, etc. So let us discuss about one by one how we are going to manufacture the metallurgical coke. By using high temperature carbonization, metallurgical coke can be prepared by two processes, Behave Cocoven process and Otto Hofmann's byproduct Cocoven process. Now, this is the equipment used for Behave Cocoven process. So let us explain, let us know how the process takes place in the Behave Cocoven process, how the coal is converted into coke, what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages. Now, this is the earliest process, it is the cheapest process, and the quality of coke produced by this process is very good. There is a lot of wastage of fuel in this process. The byproduct formed during carbonization by this process cannot be recovered, and it takes 3 to 4 days in the completion of the carbonization process. This equipment is a dome-shaped oven of 2.5 meter height, 4 meter diameter, and it has a capacity of 8 to 10 tons of coal. It is constructed by refractory bricks. One hole is provided at the top of the charging coal, and another side door is provided for discharging of coke and even for the supply of the air. The coal is charged through the top door, and if the about 0.6 meter thickened layer is formed and leveled. Slow carbonization takes place and coke formation will be completed in 3 to 4 days, but the yield of coke is about 80%, and the coke can be taken out through the side door and it can be cooled by spraying water on it. Now there are disadvantages, as I have discussed. Some of the points I have already discussed. The main disadvantages of this BEHEAV coke oven process is the byproducts are not discovered and are allowed to escape. Very small amount of coke is produced by this process. It is not very flexible and it takes 3 to 4 days to complete the whole process. So it is time consuming. The exhaust gases produces the pollution also. But due to non-recovery of the valuable products, byproducts, this is generally not used to produce a coke. It is used only as emergency unit to meet high demands for the hard coke, because we get hard coke through this process. Now let us discuss about now the Otto Hoffmann's byproduct coke oven process. By the name itself, it is shown that byproduct is recovered in this process. So let us discuss what is Otto Hoffmann's byproduct coke oven and what is the advantages of this. It is a most developed and modern byproduct coke oven, and the byproducts like coal gas, ammonia, benzol oil, tar, all these are recovered. And the heating is done externally, and heating is done on the basis of regenerative system. That is, the heat of the waste gases or flue gases is utilized in this process. So it is a byproduct coke oven process, and the heat is not allowed to waste, because the heat of the waste gases is also being utilized. This is the process. This is the schematic representation of single chamber, and this is the horizontal gas retort containing coal. So let us discuss the cross-section part. This oven consists of a rectangular silica refractory chamber, and it is of 10 to 12 meter length, 3 to 5 meter height, and 0.3 to 0.45 meter width. Each chamber is provided with an opening at the top for charging of coal, and a gas offtake, and a door for discharging of the coke. A number of such type of silica chambers are connected to form a sort of battery. About 25 to 1000 ovens can be connected in series to form a battery of such silica chambers. The battery of such ovens is placed over the regenerators having checker brickwork. The finely crushed coal is introduced through the top charging holes and are then tightly closed to cut off the supply of air, because the process of carbonization, it means the heating of coal in the absence of air to produce coke. The ovens are heated to about 1200 degrees centigrade by burning gaseous fuel like producer gas in the vertical flues. So this is the option for entry of producer gas. Air and producer gas mixture is sent here, and the gases will burn here, and the temperature maintained is about 1200 degrees centigrade. The carbonization takes place towards the central zone. The waste flue gas leaving the flues are allowed to pass through a checker brickwork in the regenerator of the next oven to preheat it, while incoming air and producer gas is passed through other preheated chambers. After some time, the directions are reversed. So in this way, the heat of the waste gases are being utilized for heating the air producer gas mixture. This cycle will go on, and the whole process will take about 11 to 18 hours. So in 11 to 18 hours, the carbonization process will get completed and coal will be converted into coke. After carbonization process, the coke is taken into quenching station. Coke is quenched rapidly cooled by wet quenching or dry quenching. Wet quenching means by spraying water. Dry quenching means by passing inert gas like nitrogen. Dry quenching is advantageous because the coke produced by it is more strong, non-reactive, drier, and it contains less dust. So we prefer dry quenching, that is by passing inert gas like nitrogen. The yield of coke is about 75%. Now, the byproduct gases will be recovered. So let us understand what are the process of recovery of byproducts. So along with coke, we have so many byproducts. Let us discuss one by one. First is recovery of tar. For recovery of tar, the coke oven gas coming out from the oven is at first passed through a tower where liquid ammonia is sprayed. The tar and dust are removed and then it can be recovered. So for the removal of tar, we are spraying liquid ammonia. Next is the byproduct that is recovered is ammonia. For the recovery of ammonia, we will be passing the gases through a tower in which water is sprayed. Ammonia will react with water to form ammonium hydroxide. It can be, instead of water, we can use even sulfuric acid. This sulfuric acid will react with ammonia to form ammonium sulfate, which can be recovered. The next byproduct that can be recovered is naphthalene. After removal of ammonia by this process, the gases are then passed through a cooling tower where water at low temperature is sprayed. Here, the naphthalene and some of the condensed gases are being recovered by this process. Now, for the recovery of benzene, the left out gases where all other byproducts are being removed, this is passed through a chamber where the petroleum is sprayed. After that, this will be sent for the recovery of H2S. The gas is passed through a chamber containing moist Fe2O3. This H2S will react with Fe2O3 and it will be converted into Fe2S3 where it is recovered. So this is the reaction. Fe2O3 plus H2S will give Fe2S3. This Fe2S3 can be treated with oxygen to get back the Fe2O3 again. The coal gas is recovered and then collected in the gas holder after passing through various chambers to remove all these products, that is tar, ammonia, naphthalene, benzene, H2S. All the recovery of all these byproducts will be done, and the left out part is nothing but the coal gas, and this is recovered after removing all these byproducts, and the calorific value of this coal gas is about 5000 kilocalorie per meter cube. That's all for today. Thank you.